Hello developers, welcome back to the channel. In the first part of this Laravel Sanctum tutorial, I have explained this SPA authentication. This is the Vue app which we have created in the previous video. In this app, a user can create a new account and a user can log in. And this is the user dashboard. And then user can log out. This is the very basic user login register authentication system using this Laravel Sanctum SPA authentication. And today in this lesson, I will explain API token authentication. So today in this lesson, I'm going to modify this existing app and we will replace this SPA with API token based authentication. So in case if you have not watched the previous video, I strongly recommend you to watch that video first before continuing this video. So if you have watched that video, so let's continue the API token authentication. And also quick reminder, if you are new to this channel, hit the red subscribe button and press bell icon so when I upload new videos you get notified. Similar to the previous video, I have opened the two editors. In this editor, I am in the Laravel app, and in the second editor, this one, it is the Vue app. I have changed the color of the editor, so you can easily recognize that this editor is for the Vue app. Now let's start the token authentication. Here, our first step is to use this has API tokens trait in the user model. Let's implement this. So in the Laravel app user model, here I'll add has API tokens and let's import its class. Here it is. In the previous video, we have already published the migration file for the Sanctum package, that is in the database migrations, this one, personal access tokens. When we will create an authentication token for the user, it is going to store that token in this table. We have already run the migration in the previous video and it has created this table right here. Our next step is to modify the login controller. Let's see this in the documentation. Here it is. I am going to copy this and paste it right here. And we need to import these classes. So let's see what here we are doing. Here first we validated the user form. In this user form, it has email, password, and new device name. Next, here we try to fetch the user with this provided email address. If user not found, or here using hash check, we verify the user password. If here it fails, then throw the validation exception with message provided credentials are incorrect. And then here we created the token for this user. And then it returned the plain text token. Now let's implement this login feature in the Vue app. So here in the Vue app, we will go to source, views, login.vue. And here on click this login button, we executed this login method. And in this login method, it hits user.login method. That is in the APIs, user.js. Right here. This login method is async method and it is also handling the CSRF get cookie. Because we are not going to use SPA authentication, we are going to use API authentication. So in that case, we don't need this CSRF get cookie. So we can remove this. Now this method no longer need to be async. Now let's see this in the browser. Let's open the inspect tool. And in the network tab, now let's navigate to login page. And here you will say harish@example.com and password is password. Let's hit the login button and here we get CSRF token mismatch. That is because in the Laravel app, in the app http kernel.php, right here in the API middleware, we have used this ensure frontend requests are stateful middleware. Because we are using token based authentication. So we no longer need this. Now let's try one more time. Password, hit login button. Now we get the validation error. And here the device name field is required. So in the Laravel app, in the login controller, here we have added the new field device name. If you want, we can remove this, and right here you can give anything you want for the token name. But for now, what I am going to do, in the view app, in the form field here, I will add device name. For the our example purpose, our device name is browser. Now let's go to browser, refresh one more time, reshetexample.com and password. Let's login. This time this login method is worked. It has given the 200 status. Now we are redirected to dashboard, and in the dashboard component it hits the user API. Right now we get the unauthorized error. We will fix this in a moment. For now let's see the login response, and in the response here we get the plain token. Now if we see in the database, refresh, and here in the personal access tokens table, this is new token for the user, and that token is sent as plain text in the response. So now in the view app, after login we get the response, and then right here we will set local storage token, that is response.data. This response.data has the plain token text. Now we have changed local storage auth into token. So we will change it number of places, like in the router index.js. Right here it is trying to fetch is user logged in, and here we will change the auth into token. Next in the components navigation.view, and right here it is also we will change get item into token. And on the logout button, here also we will change remove item token. Let's close this. Now let's try this one more time. Here we will say Harish, password is password. Clear this, and we are authenticated. Login status is 200, and we navigated to dashboard, and here the correct navigation links are appeared. Now in the application, local storage, and here we get token this. Our next step is to fix this user unauthorized error. Now to fix this in the view app, so to fix this in the dashboard.view, right here when dashboard view is mounted, it executes this mounted hook. And in this mounted hook, it is trying to fetch the authenticated user. Now if we see the user.js, here is the auth method. So to fix the unauthorized error, we need to send the authorized token with this API. We can send the authorized token from here, but I don't want that, because in that case we need to set the authorization with every new method. So instead of this, in this api.js, here we should set the authorization token. So let's see how we can do this. So first let's rename this as base API. Next here we will say let API is equal to, here I'll add closer function, and then in this closer function I'll say let token is equal to local storage dot get item and then token. Next here will say if we have token, then here will say base API dot defaults dot headers dot common, and in the square bracket here I will pass authorization is equal to, in the template literal here pass bearer and then token, and at the end here I will return base API. Because we are not using SP authentication, so now this with credential support no longer needed, so we can remove this. because this API is a closure function. So we need to modify this user.js API also. Here instead of all APIs, here will say API and parentheses. Next, in these all methods, we don't need CSRF cookie. So let's remove this. And in this logout method also, we don't need this. And we can also remove this. Now it's all done. Now let's see this in the browser. Refresh. And this time it hits the user API and we get the 200 status. And here is the user data. Now we don't have to worry about this token. Here this API will add the authorized token with every API request. Next we need to fix this logout. So in the Laravel app, right here in this logout method, I will remove this created token. So he'll say request dollar request and then dollar request user tokens delete. And finally, let's return response JSON logout 201 status. Now let's see this in the browser. So clear this. Now if we click this logout button, we got 500 error. Let's see this. Call to member function token on null. Error is right here. This error is because in the API route, right here in this logout route, here we need to add this middleware. Now let's try this. Refresh. We are logged in. Let's clear this. Now if we hit this logout button, it worked and we are logged out. Let's try one more time. Let's register the new user. First we hit the register button. We got validation error. Harry@example.com and password, confirm password, register. We successfully got registered. Now let's login this Harry@example.com and password. Let's login. Failed. Type password again. Now we are authenticated and logged in. Now if we try to hit the login page, it will not allow us. Let's go to register page. It will not allow us to go to register page because we are already logged in. Let's log out and try to hit the dashboard. It will not allow us and redirect to the login page. This is all in this token-based authentication. In the documentation, you can read more about this token-based authentication. You can also create tokens based on the ability, like here, create token and this ability. And right here is the example how you can validate that ability. See this documentation and try this out in your project. This is all in this lesson. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next lesson.